Well, have you started your New Year's resolution, and are you hoping to stick with it? Well, getting fit is the most popular resolution, but of course it also happens to be the resolution that's given up on the most. This morning we have some 2020 fitness tips that are simple and effective that are going to help you stay on track. Here with us this morning is David Patterson. He's actually also the KHON2 assignment manager, but happens to be a fitness trainer. Good morning, Dave.
Well, good morning. Thank you. And by the way, 2020, this is going to be my resolution, too, because I slacked in 2019. So I'm not being a preacher. I'm hoping to practice.
Okay, and as am I, because 2019, it was good to me in the fact that I ate too much good food. But the wedding is coming up this year, so I got to get fit. I'm ready. I have motivation. Okay, so when it comes to resolutions, again, a lot of people do give up. Why is it that they give up so quickly?
And you know what? It's too hard. That's what people think. Or it takes too much time. And, you know, what I want to talk about is that you don't really need that much time to get fit. You just got to do it.
Right. So what tips do you have for folks to get on track and keep on track?
Okay. You know, we're talking about time, and that's an issue. Because a lot of times when you think about working out or going to a gym, you think, oh, it might be an hour. And it's really easy to say, you know what? I don't have an hour today. You always have 20 minutes. I mean, we have more than 20 minutes to look at this all the time, right?
Oh, yeah.
You know, so, or we'll spend 20 minutes just laying on the couch watching TV. You always have 20 minutes. So the idea is to make these workouts quick and effective. And they've got to have some intensity in it. You know, I've seen people on treadmills for an hour and they still look the same. It's better than sitting on the couch, but that's where it's easy for them to give up too. It's like, you know, I'm on for an hour and nothing has happened. So, yeah, the idea is to make them quick and have some intensity in it, and I'll show you some of those.
Okay, yeah, let's do it. What's a good example of a quick workout?
Well, I like to use the high-intensity interval training because it's creative.
And that's called HIIT, right?
You got it.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly. So, and you know, you want them to be creative and fun, so then you're looking forward to and mixing up the exercise. I'll just show you some quick things. So the first thing is core is really important, and core just isn't sit-ups. I mean, you can do, here, take a weight.
Okay.
And even with core, you can just.
These are heavy weights, 10 pounds, no big deal.
You can just do something like this, and always, in every exercise you do, tighten your core.
Yes.
Even when we do, you know, some of the other exercises I'm going to show you, like presses and squats, because if your core is tight, then everything else is even better for you. And the best way to tighten your core is...
I was ready.
Flex, right? Because a lot of people stick their stomach out or suck it in, and then you can't breathe. So just flex it like, you know, a kid was going to hit you in your tummy or something like that. So, all right, so core...
Oh,
is one of them.
This is working your arms and obliques.
Right, there you go. And that's another thing about exercises. You know, a lot of machine exercises, you're just focusing on one area. What I'm going to show you is how you can do upper body and lower body resistance while always tightening your core, and you get some cardio out of it.
Okay, and that's an easy one.
Right, okay.
Perfect.
And then, of course, there are things like planks and stuff like that. Okay, so the next thing I want to show you is lower body resistance. What is it that we do the most in life?
Mm-hmm.
We sit down and we stand up. And when it gets more difficult as we get older, it's because of our inactivity. But it's not really because we're getting older. It's because we're not being active. So we need to strengthen the glutes and the quads. So this is what I want to show you.
Okay.
And we can put a weight down.
Okay.
Okay. And I want you to face this way so we can see. Okay. The most important thing is get your butt back a little bit. Okay, like that. Okay, shoulders retracted a bit, chin tucked. And what I want you to make sure is when you squat down, think of it as you're sitting in a chair, okay? Good, because your knees won't be in front of your toes.
Mm-hmm.
So where are you feeling it right now?
At the moment?
Yeah.
For the most part, in my...
Right, and then, and tighten those glutes, too, as you come to the top.
Yes.
So the important thing about this is that if you feel it in the knees, that's not good. This is not a workout for your knees. It's for your quads and your glutes. And now it's going to be a lot. It's easy to sit down in a couch because you just plop down. But when you got to get back up to say, oh, you know what? I better go exercise. Now it'll be easier to do.
Right.
And even getting in and out of the car. Now I want to show you the right form for, because the other thing we do in life is we're lifting things all the time.
Right.
Okay. So hold these. They are heavy.
Okay.
And again, turn this way.
Wish me luck, you guys.
Right. Now, okay. Bend your knees a little bit.
Okay.
Okay. And you don't need to squat.
Or just a little bit.
Yeah, put your arms out this way. okay? And then just go straight up through your ear. You got your chin
tucked.
How is that? That's very good. That form is good. That's one of the most important things, people, because that's another thing I see in gyms, people working out incorrectly, and then you're not hurting yourself.
Right.
Okay, that's good. You can put that.
Okay,
down.
So that's important. Of course, right. You want to stick with something. Make sure it's something simple, something that you can actually commit to. But a little bit does go a long way. So even if you're starting out with small goals in 2020, it'll help you get there. Thank you so much, David,
welcome.
For joining us this morning. More when we come back. Stay with us.